Hello students, hope you all are good. I welcome you all. I already completed the detailed explanation and the literary technical terms of the poem as it is the last part of this poem. So today I will provide you the themes along with the conclusion. So the first theme of the poem is poverty. Stephen Spender creates an image of children in poverty through his description of dire situation and malnourished students, revealing a sad, hidden section of society that was prevalent throughout the world. So he is talking about that kind of society in which the sadness lurks and the malnourished children are shown in that type of society. He is not commenting directly on any particular nation in his poem. He is not talking about only a single nation. He is talking in a whole. Instead, he exposes the widespread neglect of the children of all nationalities and races. Okay, so he is just talking about the children, the slum area children or the neglected children of all the nationalities and the races who belong to all the nationalities and different races. It is the poverty that has caused the student in an elementary school classroom to be wrecked down, paper seeming, diseased and twisted. So due to the poverty, the effect of the children are just shown in this poem. So what are the effects of the children? What are the effects they are having in their life? They are just wrecked down, they are paper seeming, diseased and twisted. Alright. Spender believes this poverty is created through the oppressive power of the upper class. So he is saying that this poverty is a kind of a gift of the upper class people. Alright. Spender was affected by the struggles for equality in the United States because of his social and political reforms. So he just focuses on the social and political reforms of the country, and he used to belong to the social community or the political factors he just influenced in his career. Alright. Although this poem was written during the time of racial injustice in America, I already told you all that this poem was written during the civil rights movement in America, and in that time the racial justice was very prevalent in United States. Spender does not directly focus on selected group of underprivileged children. So the poet does not only focus on a selected group of children or selected group of slum area students. Alright, because he is just talking about many nations. He is just including the condition or the situation of many nations. Alright, he is not just focusing on United States only. Alright, so he just focuses on the world, the condition or the situation of the world, the children who are neglected, and he is just talking about the widespread of this system, the disgusting system, the malnourished students and the malnourished children, how they are neglected, okay, how they are taken advantage of. Alright, so he does not directly focus on a selected group of underprivileged children based on race, religion or the creed. So in his poem, he is not just focusing on a particular group of children, and he is just not biased. He is just not biased with any kind of religion, race or creed. He is just talking about the children or the students in a whole. Alright. Instead, he remarks about the social injustice imposed upon all children. So he also just talk about the social injustice which the society is facing, okay, with the children, with the poor children are facing, or the poor families are facing, because they are just neglected, they are just avoided, and they are just deprived of many facilities in their lifetime. Okay, and the facilities which are provided to the upper class people, the government who provides the facilities to the upper class people, or the system who provides the facility to the upper class people, the same facilities are not given to the lower class people. All right. So, regardless of their upbringing, history, race, children are innocent beings. Okay. So, their upbringing is not so good because they belong from a lower class family. All right. And their history, their race, obviously, they are very different from the upper class people. They are very different from the higher class people because as they are belonging to the lower class, lower section of the society, obviously their upbringing will be a kind of different from the upper class people. So the children are very innocent. The slum area children are very innocent in nature, dependent on the helping hands of humanity. They are very much dependent on the helping hands. What kind of helping hand? I must say the helping hand. What kind of helping hand? The helping hand from the upper class. Alright. The helping hand from the upper class people. Because you all know that in my last few classes, I just mentioned about the donations they were given. The upper class used to give some kind of donation to the lower class people, lower class children. And this were a kind of a help. Though it didn't turn out to be good, then also it was a kind of a help to them. So they they always depend on the kind of a help or the helping hands from the upper class people. Alright. Spender brings out these emotions in this poem and delivers a powerful message about poverty. So he just bring out this kind of emotion, this kind of feelings in this poem, and delivers a kind of a very powerful message to the readers, to the audience. Its effect on the children, and how does poverty affect the future of the children. Okay, he just focuses on that, and also how the poverty affect the the education. All right, how the children are deprived of the good quality of education. He just focuses on that, and the oppressive power of money, and he also focuses on the power of money. Okay, because he just give an example to us that if the higher class people, are very rich, they are very affluent. Okay, so they are not deprived of anything. They are getting the each and every facilities from the system. And simultaneously, whereas the lower class people, they are very much needy. They are very much needy, and they are deprived of the facilities. Okay. And some of the donation they have been given from the higher class, but this donation doesn't turn out to be good for them, because this donation is a kind of temptation for them. Alright. So the second theme of this poem is education. It is a very important thing. Education. It is a key theme. Okay. Spender does not appreciate the donation given to the children. As I told you earlier also that the donation the upper class people used to give to the lower class children, it was a kind of temptation to them. And why temptation? Because they used to provide the lower class people a kind of a donation, and in return of that, they used to provoke the children to do a kind of a illegal work. Okay, their criminal activities. Alright. So, because he sees them as a direct intervention of upper class society in the school. And because it is a kind of intervention, the direct intervention. Why direct intervention? Because when the upper class people are giving the lower class people a donation for their good, but in return they are having a selfish motive. The upper class people is having a kind of a selfish motive in return, and they just tempt those children to do some criminal activities or do some illegal work in the return of the donation provided to them. All right, so the donation given by the upper class people is not so good as the readers and the audience used to think. All right, so just we are thinking that we readers or we audience are just thinking that the upper class people are providing a good amount, a good quality of donations to the slum area children for their betterment. But these donation is a kind of a temptation to them. This donation is proved to be a kind of a temptation to them, which tempt the slum area children or the poor children to do some illegal work in their life, because they are very much forced to live in their condition. Okay, the students are very much forced to live in that type of condition so that they cannot go out from their slum area ever in their lifetime. All right, this donation are not given for the good of the children's education, but for the sole purpose of keeping them in a position as lower class citizen. As I told you just now, that this donation, why this donation has been given? Because this donation is given because the children, the lower class children, have been forced to stay in their own condition. Okay, the upper class people always make it sure that these lower class families or these lower class children won't be getting out from their slum region or won't be getting a kind of a better life. Okay, I must say won't be getting a kind of a better life or better way of living. So these upper class people force the lower class sections to stay or to live in the particular situation they are living in the present time. All right, so this end is achieved in that, and the donation project evolved outside the slum that is seemingly difficult to achieve and thus press the children into lives of unfulfilled dreams or of crime. So the donation that are provided to the students, just the donation is having a kind of a purpose, is having a purpose. What purpose it is having? Because when the upper class people is giving the lower class a donation, the donation is tempting them. Okay, alright. And why it is tempting them? Because it is showing a world outside the slum that is impossible to achieve for them. Okay, that is, the donation are showing something which is very different from their world, which is very different from their slum area region, which is very different from their world, and which is unattainable, which is impossible to achieve. And this situation leads the slum area children to be a criminal. Okay, because by this they are very much provoked to do any illegal activities or criminal activities. All right, Spender asks for a change in which money empowers the children to truly explore books, maps, the world and themselves too, and would give them the chance to pursue education. So Spender is requesting the government that this small type of donation won't be helpful for them. Okay, Spender is talking to the government or talking to the system, or he is having a request to the system. All right, so he is having a plea to the government that these small donations won't be very much helpful to the students, as this donation are tempting them, they are taking them to a wrong path, wrong direction. So the government should make it sure that they must invest their money, the government should invest some of the money, some of the fund for these children, for this lower section, and so that they can achieve a good quality of education. Okay, and which will include books, maps and walls, and they will also explore themselves too. Because when we are studying, when we are learning, when we are gaining knowledge, each and every person in this world, we are exploring ourselves. Because the more you learn, we will explore us. Okay, explore us means what? कि हम जितना स्टडीज करेंगे, हम जितना लर्न करेंगे, हम जितना नॉलेज अटेन करेंगे, ऑल राइट, हम उतना ही अपने आप को जान पाएंगे अच्छे से, हम उतना ही अपने आसपास के सराउंडिंग्स को जान पाएंगे अच्छे से, हर चीज़ को जान पाएंगे. लेकिन ईच एंड एवरीथिंग, हर एस्पेक्ट लाइफ का, हर एक फेस को जानने के लिए, नेचर में क्या हो रहा है, सराउंडिंग में क्या हो रहा है, हर एक चीज़ को जानने के लिए सबसे पहले ज़रूरी है खुद को जानना. ऑलराइट, सो फॉर दैट पर्पस वी हैव टू अटेन नॉलेज, वी हैव टू लर्न समथिंग. अंटिल एंड अनलेस वी लर्न समथिंग, इट इज़ जस्ट इम्पॉसिबल फॉर अस टू एक्सप्लोर आवरसेल्फ और टू एक्सप्लोर द वर्ल्ड. ऑलराइट, दैट इज व्हाट द पोएट इज सेइंग, दैट the government should focus to fund these children, fund these poor children, so that they can buy books, maps, and they can explore themselves, and they can explore their books too, so that they just keep on learning. Okay, and would give them a chance to pursue education, and this would provide them a chance to pursue a good quality education, good quality knowledge. All right, Spender does not wish to remove education from society. Obviously, the poet Stephen Spender does not want to remove education from society, because he just says that education is an integral part of our society. Okay, so education is a main part of our society, so it is very, what I will say, it is quite impossible to say, it is quite it will be quite wrong to say that education is not integral part of the society. All right, because it will be quite wrong that if we are going to say that education doesn't affect us. Okay, it will be quite wrong. So Spender is saying that he is not trying to remove education from society, rather he is trying to give a message to the audience or the readers that a good quality of education is needed in our society. Okay, a good quality of education is needed in which there will be no partiality. Okay, the quality of education which will be given to each and every person in this world, each and every student in this world, so that there will be no partiality in imparting education. All right, so but he aspires to transform it into an institution where all children are given the opportunity to excel. So he just wish to give a kind of education where there is no partiality, no partiality of higher class or upper class, no partiality of religion nor race, okay, and nor the creed. All right, so education which is free of, he is just saying to imparting an education which is just free of any kind of race, religion, culture, creed, race and ethnicity. All right, and obviously the most important thing is the classes, higher class and lower class. So each and every class of our society, though it is a higher class, though it is a lower class, each and every person in this world out there should attain knowledge. Okay, they are having the right to attain knowledge. Now this is the second theme of the poem, that is the education. Next, coming to the third theme of the poem, that is the knowledge. It is also very important theme. So knowledge and its effect is a key theme in the poem. Ability to transform education and uproot poverty. Spender's effort stands for education above everything as the most important influence on the future of humanity. So knowledge is very much important to us. To attain knowledge will be very much fruitful for each and every person in this world. Okay, and this is a kind of a key theme. This is a very important theme of the poem. And by gaining knowledge, the students will transform their societies. Okay, the slum area students will transform their condition as well as their societies. How? By gaining knowledge, by learning something. Okay, until and unless they will learn or gain some knowledge, they will be unable to transform their condition or their society. Alright, so for this, education is above everything and it also influences the future of humanity. Manavta ke liye bahut zaruri hai education. Alright, it's very important for the mankind, the human race. For Spender, children minds possess the power of sun. So in this fourth stanza, you might be remembering the line that poet is saying that the children mind is possessing a power of sun. Okay, the language is the sun. Okay, so the children mind possesses a power of a sun and the ability to clear the fog from the bleak future. So when they will attain something, they will gain knowledge, they will learn something, their mind, the mind which is the sun, which is having the power of sun, will be able to clear the fog from the bleak future. Means what? They will remove the darkness from their life when they will attain some knowledge and when they will gain some knowledge. Alright, and when they will attain a good position in their life, then they will just clear their darkness, remove their darkness from their life. So their mind, which is the power of sun, will be able to clear the fog from the bleak future. Alright, these students empowered by honest education can achieve a mental stability. Obviously, the education will also give them, provide them a mental stability that will free them from futures painted with fog. Obviously, that when they will gain knowledge, their future will no longer be dark and they will achieve a good future, a bright future. With knowledge, the children can change the future. They can raise their educated minds in revolt and turn the oppression that desperately tries to keep them in place. So by educating themselves, they can revolt against the wrong deeds. They can revolt against the wrong deeds that are happening in the society. It means what? By education, with the help of education, after educating them, they can revolt against the wrong things that are happening around the world, yeah, around themselves. Alright, and turn the operation that desperately tries to keep them in place, and they can turn the power of the higher class people, turn the operation which who just always forces the slum area children or the lower section to keep them in their place. Okay, this just forces them to be there in that particular situation or condition. His theme means, in short, poet is trying to say that after getting education, these students will be able to revolt against the wrong thing that are happening around them as well as the wrong the upper classes is doing to them. Alright, his theme of knowledge and revolution in the poem is intended to shed light on the power of education. Obviously, the power of education has been focused. Okay, what is the power of education? The light had been shed upon it. So, and the necessity to change the society. And what is the necessity to change the society? And how the people will change the society after gaining education, after learning something, is very much important. And deliver knowledge to all the people. And after education, how the people will deliver knowledge, it is most important thing in our society, regardless of social or economic position. Though there won't be any kind of partiality of social or economic status. Alright, so last topic of today is the allegory of the poem. Spender uses the classroom and the children in his poem as an allegory. What is the allegory? You will just come to know about the struggle between lower class and the upper class. So Spender is saying that he is just focusing on the students of the classroom, the slum area region, and the classroom too. So here the classroom and the students, those who are present in the classroom, is a kind of an allegory in the poem. Alright, and the struggle of the lower class and the upper class, then it is the section of the lower section and the higher section has been shown in this particular poem, that the struggle they are going through, the difficulties they are going through, the lower class people, has been focused in this poem. The children in an elementary school classroom in a slum are clearly underprivileged and lower class, and the classroom donors are wealthy upper class, and these classroom donors which are donating the children, slum area children, are wealthy and they are belonging from an upper class section. Okay, so thus the poem tells about the poor condition of the students, and the students are in very poor condition, and the future of the students is bleak, is very dark. Alright, the story also teaches us the value of education. What is the power of education and what is the value of education? The story just teaches or give us a kind of a message to the readers, and the value of all the things that we possess and many do not, and value of many things, value of the good way living, value of the education, value of the knowledge, and what is the value of the money in the society. Because without money, we just can see that the lower sections are avoided and neglected because they are not having they are not wealthy, they are not having money, and also they are not educated. Alright, so by this we come to the end of this lecture. Every topics had been covered. So from the next virtual class, that means from Wednesday onwards, I will start giving question and answers of each and every poetry chapters. Alright, it is a very important announcement, student. Just carefully listen to it, that from next virtual class, that means from Wednesday onwards, I will start giving you the question answers of each and every poetry chapters for your boards exams. Alright, I will be starting straight from the chapter 1. I will be doing the chapters sequentially now. I will just providing you the question answer in a sequence after chapter 1, then I will move ahead to the chapter 2. Okay. So I will be starting from chapter 1 in my next class. So on Wednesday, meet you all with the detailed question answers for your upcoming exams. Just pay attention, students, that the given questions, the question I will provide it to you. The question I will give it to you. Okay. And also the answers, you will just try to memorize it, or you may write in your own words too if you are good in English. Okay, so if you can write well in English, you can write it in your own words too. I'm not having any kind of issues in it, though I will provide the question and answers both. The particular, just pay attention, the questions I will provide to you along with the answer will be asked definitely in your board exams. Alright, the question I will give it to you will definitely be asked in your exam. So just prepare it well and be careful, be attentive in these classes. So therefore, those who had missed the lectures, kindly attend to it positively. We may be unable to provide you all offline classes. I'm not sure, but we may be unable to provide you all a kind of an offline class due to this pandemic situation. God knows what is going to happen. We don't know actually till now whether our institution will allow us to do offline classes or not. We are not sure about it. So just keep that in your mind, that till the end of this year, or more, two months more, you have to just go through these lectures for your preparations for your studies. Alright. So, it is my request, that just go through the online classes. It's very important for you all, because now, from now onwards, it's very important to focus on your online classes, as question and answers I will give, and that particular question and answers are going to come in your exams. Okay, keep learning and keep growing. Subscribe to my channel for the latest updates and stay tuned. Bye bye, take care.